Shifting focus over to other international stories, in the UK's hospitality sector has taken a dramatic financial hit since they were ordered to close down in the month of March. Now, the step was taken shortly before the government imposed a full lockdown to limit the spread of the novel coronavirus. Post-lockdown, Britain's restaurant business faces bigger changes. The government schemes have kept many hospitality businesses afloat, but with reduced footfall, restaurants are a long way from recovering. Some will likely even go bankrupt.
It's almost certain that we're going to see a number of businesses move into administration through this process. And I do think that because of what we talked about before, of the challenge, particularly for larger businesses and larger city centre type locations, I think we are going to see a number of the well-known brands that people love and know really be the ones that we will see go into administration.
Michelin star winning chef Andrew Wong believes London's vibrant high-end restaurant sector will be transformed by COVID-19. He thinks that improvisation is needed as no one knows how the measures would affect the dining experience and how customers and staff will be impacted.
Now, this is a live experience. How comfortable do customers feel with this idea of being 2 meters apart? Or at what point do you say, you know what, your staff cannot get any closer to the customer? At what point does it no longer be comfortable for the staff member? At what point does it no longer become comfortable for the guest? I think those things we can't answer yet. I think those things will be waiting for it to roll and then seeing what we do.
Avion's London Bureau Chief Mandy Clark brings us more details.
2.9 million people are employed by the hospitality sector here in Britain, but it's facing an existential threat. If restaurants will hope to reopen, then they're going to have to abide by social distancing rules. Now, that's a complete game changer for their revenue model that has always seen tightly packed restaurants serving a lot of meals just to cover the costs. Some restaurants are diversifying, offering takeouts, online cooking courses, and even recipe boxes. But will that be enough to save the industry? Only time will tell. Mandy Clark, World is One, We On, London.